Greetings, everyone. My name is Ettervel, and I welcome you all to my blind live let's play of Moon Raider, an indie 2D action platformer shooter developed by Cascadia Games and published by Crescent Moon Games. For full disclosure, I received a key from the developer in order to help Peter title. And as this is a blind let's play, I apologize in advance for any silly mistakes or false assertions I'll make. That was fast. Our first boss battle. On the top left is our health bar, below that is a gem counter, and on the top center of the screen, I'm not sure what that's counting. For first boss, that was pretty easy. I think we'll encounter that figure in the late game. Ow, those were thorns. So we need to find at least 200 of them to save Ava's mother. Hopefully none of them are too hidden. This game has 10 areas in total, but each area has multiple zones. Nice, a health upgrade. And as you can hear, the audio is glitching out a bit. Hopefully this doesn't become too big of a problem. My gem counter on the left maxes out at 99. Thank you. Let's check down first. It seems if I hold down the fire button for long enough, the shots will turn red and the weapon will fire faster. So far, all the controls are pretty responsive. The main thing that sticks out to me is the audio. It seems it wasn't programmed correctly. I don't have that many iframes either. Nope, Jaden. These Selenians only disintegrate. What were those other two games, Jaden? Hold on for a moment. Boss time. Darn, you stole all of it. A bit tougher than the drill bot. I see. What's up here? A secret. It's a bonus room. To stock up on gem energy. As for those two games, Jaden, I think I know which ones you're referring to, both of which I did pre-recorded last tries of. Those were done for the Steam Summer Festival. So that marks the end of the first zone. On to zone 2. And already I reached the second bonus room. Each one of these areas has a bonus zone. Wait, can I circumvent? I can. I won't cheese it that much. I want to see what's down below. Don't touch the lava. Got it. There may be a moon crystal down there. Using a dash drains my gem energy quite quickly, so I need to be careful when I decide to use it. It apparently also one-shots these foot soldiers. Eh, it's not too bad. None of these rooms are too long. If I decided to speedrun that last room, it would have taken 1/3 of the total time. More speedrunning tech. All thanks to those platforms. But I need to see what's down over here. And there was something important. All the enemies and objects respawn once you exit a screen. Perhaps, Jaden, perhaps. Looking at the store page and the reviews, I get the strong impression that this is a budget title. This game was also released for macOS, the Switch, and mobile devices, and a few other ones which I'm forgetting. These shoot open doors remind me of Metroid. Notice how all these statues of Ava's mother are cracked. So now I can hold even more gem energy. That'll be handy for general level traversal and bosses. I wonder why the Selenians decided to overthrow the queen. Ah, you stole my gem energy again. Oh, I didn't realize that Ava could damage enemies that way. That marks the end of the volcanic area. And my first death by laser. I probably can't dash through it. Bonus round number 3. Just what I needed. The chiptune soundtrack does sound nice. I simply wish it didn't sound so scratchy. Oh, I saw it at the last moment. It actually resets to where I last entered the room. True that, Cook Serve Delicious Trees soundtrack is better than this one. Then again, that game had a much bigger budget. Before I decide to let's play this game, I decided to search it on Google. I discovered that this was a Kickstarter title, with a goal of $8,000. They were able to fundraise about $9,000. So I can dash through them. Probably not the yellow ones, however. Never mind, I can phase through these lasers too. That makes the dash even better. It already one-shots most enemies. The only downside is how much gem energy it costs. I really need to play Spark the Electric Jester 1 and 2. As long as I tap the dash button, it doesn't use that much energy. Only one energy per tap. And I lose everything I collected in the room after I die. Unless I hit a checkpoint. So I can damage enemies by somersaulting onto them, but it damages Ava too. I'm not exactly sure what's causing it. Hang on, I'll fix it. Sorry about that. The game was quieter earlier. The rest of the game audio will be adjusted in post. One of those games with subpar audio balancing. Cracking appears to happen when there are a lot of sound effects playing at the same time. Yet again, I should have waited a bit more. Currently, dashing feels somewhat overpowered. It's basically my solution to most stage hazards and enemies. Once again, sorry folks, it's one of those games that didn't properly audio balance. Next boss battle. It appears that every boss, barring the very first one, steals my gem energy. Don't worry, this game so far hasn't been too tough. I would not have died as much if I rushed less. Well, I expected as much.
I'm sorry.